What did you get, David?
So for not A and B, we just take the value of A and B and flip it. A and B is only true when both are true. So when both are true, this becomes false. And any other time, this becomes true. Not A or not B becomes true whenever either of them are false, because the false value will be flipped by that negation, and that's all that'll matter because this is an OR. So we see A is false here and here, B is false here, so those are all true. When they're both true, this becomes false because both those truth values are flipped.
That's good, David. So the De Morgan's law is saying that when we try to distribute the negation over the predicates inside the parentheses that are connected with a conjunction, then the conjunction becomes a disjunction between the negations of the predicates. The same would have been true if we had a disjunction here. When we distribute the negation, it would have become a conjunction here. David, before we go ahead further, let's remember why we are trying to do all of this. So recall we said in the beginning of the lesson that a logical agent will have a knowledge base and then formal rules of inference that will apply on the sentences of the knowledge base. The knowledge base itself may be coming from many places. Some sentences in the knowledge base may be bootstrapped into the logical agent. Other sentences may be coming from perception. Now, when we are trying to apply these rules of inferences to the sentences in the knowledge base, it is sometimes very useful to rewrite these sentences in different forms. And that's what we are trying to do. These properties will allow us to rewrite the sentences in such a way that we can in fact apply the rules of inferences that we will see in a minute.